Jade called me. She's taking the explosives to Saeed. She wanted me to talk to Rahim about the volatile hive and how she wants him to stay the hell away from it.
Crane, Saeed told me about the explosives you guys found. How perfect is that? Jade gave them to him. Saeed used to be on a bomb squad, so he knows about that stuff.
Yeah, kid. That was a lucky find. Would have been better to turn up some antis in, though.
My buddy Omar is making sure Saeed's putting good timers on those things. We have to be able to get our asses out of there before they blow.
Whoa, we? There's no we in this. I mean, yeah, that nest needs to go, and now it's possible, but... But if it gets done, I'm doing it on my own.
But... it's my plan.
And I will execute it perfectly, I promise.
But... ah, shit. There's no use arguing with you, is there? Fine. I'll contact you as soon as Saeed's finished with the charges.
Rahim, do we have a deal?
I guess.
Do we have a deal?
Yes. We have a deal.
Okay, one more thing. I keep seeing this bizarre kind of infected. Is Dr. Zara out at his trailer? I'd like to talk to him about it.
Nah, he's down in sick bay visiting Dr. Lena.
Thanks, kid. I'll see you soon. Hey, Doc, you got a minute?
Oh, it's, Kane. Yes. How can I help you?
Crane, remember when I told you about that weird infected I saw? You know, the one who took one look at me and hauled ass away? Yeah, well, I just saw another one, and it did the same thing.
I believe I have heard your colleagues talk about those creatures. Bolters, they call them. Apparently, they favor certain areas of town over others, but only appear at night. I don't suppose you could catch one and bring me a sample of its flesh. You see, a thought occurred to me. A long shot, I realize. But if these creatures favor areas where I left my experimental bait, well, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Please do obtain a sample, but it has to be fresh. So you have to get it back to me quickly.
Okay, and where exactly do I find these things?
I'm told that quartermaster chap has been keeping track of them.
Seems there's some survivors at the bazaar, and the witch is one of them. Guess if anyone's gonna bullshit their way to safety, it's gonna be Dahlia, right?
Did you say she's a witch?
She says she's a witch. She claims the infected won't even touch her because of her voodoo hocus pocus. They say she walked clean across the city without getting touched at night.
Maybe she knows something we don't.
Yeah, maybe. Or maybe she's just completely full of shit.
I saw some people in this school. Gotta wonder what they were doing there.
Zara asked me to bring him a sample from that bolter I saw in front of the school. He said they'd been spotted in specific areas of the city, so I should focus my search in those places. He also said I needed to get that sample back to him while it was still fresh. So I gotta move.
There's a lot to be done around the tower. Hope you find some time to take a look at the board.
Walkie-talkies work much better. I wonder what happened.
What can I do for you?
Doc Zera says you know where I should look for these, bolters. Super fast infected, covered in big green blisters.
Oh, yeah. I can point you in the right direction. Here, and here. Though you ask me, if trouble don't come looking for you, no reason to go looking for trouble.
Words to live by, thanks.
Come here. I've got a spec. Special deal for you.
Rahim's electronic parts. Don't expect the radios to work any better. The truth is, Rahim is trying to build a robot runner. He gets these crazy ideas in his head.
There's a lot to be done around the tower.
Hope you find some time to take a look at the board.
Hey, what's up, Spike?
Just FYI, if you need me, I'll be at the ferry station to help Morgan prep the barge.
Get off! Get off me! Get off!
Thank you so much for helping me.
Thank you.
special right there.
Attention! Attention! Since you cannot hear dog whistles, we are forced to communicate with you directly. You are ordered to come immediately.
This is Crane. Is that you, Tolga?
He wants to talk to us.
Well, I don't want to talk to him. I repeat, you are ordered to come immediately. That is all.
Shut off the radio!
Right!
Hey, Crane, we've got a job for you. Crane, that dynamite of yours, I'm making it into an anti-personnel bomb. It'll mow down the infected like a harvester. I'm going to combine it with firecrackers and a load of shrapnel, but I'm missing a few things. Starting with a suitable casing. A battery from a truck would be perfect. There's this big truck on the overpass. Well, it's hanging over the edge of the overpass, but you're an athletic type, huh? You'll be fine.
Oh, God.
I got your battery, Kurt.
Okay, so we've got the casing. Next, I'll need some metal scrap from the junkyard to use for shrapnel. After that, I need sugar and some cables. Try the shops or warehouses. Bring them back, and you'll get a bomb that'll blast 100 infected at once.
Sold. This should take care of the shrapnel.
Good job, Crane.
Sugar, not the cleanest.
It doesn't matter. We're making a bomb, not a cup of tea.
Are these cables all right?
They'll do. All right, we've got everything. Give me some time. I'll let you know when I'm done.
We don't want to break him.
Should we smile?
To what purpose?
Looking ridiculous.
Hey, boys. What are we into this time?
Do you understand what a battery is?
Tolga, you're overwhelming him. Inside the engine compartment of a bus is a heavy rectangle.
I know what a battery is.
Okay, we need bus batteries with marine-grade plates.
Okay, I'll see you there.
And rated at 1300 CCA or better.
CCA means cold cranking amps.
Obviously.
That's a pretty big battery.
Yes, easily 50 to 55 kilograms each.
That's equal to several large rocks. He's American. The metric system makes him angry.
We will need three of them.
Oh, you can use your brute strength. We know you primitives are keen to show how strong you are, to demonstrate physical prowess.
You think it will attract females?
Ugly and stupid. What else does he have?
How does he live like that?
Who knows? You have your instructions. Go do your, interpretation of them.
I just want to talk.
Try listening. The first bullet goes over your head. The next one goes through it.
Stop it, Edward. You don't want to scare off someone who might be willing to help us.
We don't know this arsehole from a plate of falafel.
Don't argue with me. Let him in.
Seems Errol wants to talk to you.
There won't be any trouble.
Do I look worried?
Scared to death.
He's perceptive. Come in, come in. I'm Errol.
Kyle Crane.
This is my niece, Salier, and her son, Aaron. Do forgive Edward, but he's completely right to be worried. We're being pursued by some very ruthless men.
There's something oddly familiar about you.
There should be. The campaign spent a lot of money putting my face all over town.
Of course, you're Errol Asani, governor of the province.
Governor of nothing, but Rise has decided that any political figure is a threat to him. So he's ordered my execution. They nearly killed me once already. That's how I lost my leg. And it seems they haven't given up. A squad of his thugs has tracked me to my last safe house in the slabs. Edward was just there. He says they're searching the area. It's only a matter of time before they show up here.
Sounds like you got quite a problem.
I would pay you very well to resolve it.
You know, people say that a lot to me.
Trust me. What I can offer you can't be found anywhere else, at any price.
And I'll think about it.
Right here. Let's do this. Don't be like that. Calm down. Let's do this. Don't be like that. Calm down. Let's do this. I'm not done with you.
I'm just glad they're dead.
Thank you, my friend. If you hadn't come along when you did, they would have beaten us to death.
Stay where you are, you undead freak!
You got a bomb for me?
I've got the prototype. It's on the table, ready to be tested. There's a barricaded tunnel nearby. It's chock full of volatiles during the day. But at night, it should be pretty clear. You won't find a better place to test a bomb.
Okay, I'll try the tunnel and let you know how it went.
One more thing. Remember about the firecrackers. The bomb will go off as soon as they're done popping. That's how much time you have to get the hell away. Good luck.
Finally. I was getting worried you weren't coming.
You keep pumping red smoke in the air, you're gonna have all kinds of visitors.
Red's all I had left. Anyway, you're here, so it did the job. Give this envelope to Aziz at the bazaar. Tell him it's from Ryan.
Red phosphorus, lye, iodine, muriatic acid, diethyl ether, phenyl nitrate. Geez, not exactly grandma's recipe for Christmas cookies. Lena, this is Crane. Are you there?
Lena's tied up. Can I help you?
Someone just gave me a grocery list with red phosphorus, lye, iodine, muriatic acid, diethyl ether, and phenyl nitrate.
Then someone just gave you a recipe for cooking slam. Rise's crews have been using it to stay up for days at a time. Volatiles are more reasonable than someone tanked up on that stuff.
Maybe I should put this guy out of business.
Actually, we're pretty desperate for phenyl nitrate. It's a lab-grade disinfectant, and we're completely out of it.
Well, you want me to pick up his shopping list?
Definitely. Then find me at the tower. I've got an idea that should throw a monkey wrench into the operation.
Thank you.
Kurt?
I'm here, Crane.
It's no good. It's not working.
Not working? Huh. That's unexpected. All right. A little on-the-fly surgery should do the trick. First, open the casing by making an incision just below the negative terminal post. Peel back the casing along the incision line to reveal the trigger wiring harness. Now, check the solder on two green wires and the three red ones. I'm betting it's the green wire. I was drinking when I did them, which I now realize was perhaps irresponsible of me.
Oh, that did it. Blew up the nest and the barricade. All right, the tunnel's now passable.
Hey, I told you, my friend, if I build it, it's going to explode. Come see me, and I'll give you the blueprint.
This is for you. I've also modified the case a bit. Cans instead of batteries. Smaller bang, but cans are easier to find and to carry.
All right. Thanks, Kurt.
city.
You Aziz? Ryan sent me.
What happened to Assam?
What do you think?
You guys take a lot of chances out there. Look, I've got everything but the phenyl nitrate.
And you don't have what I need, and that's not gonna cut it with Ryan.
What can I do? The courier wrecked his car in the tunnel last night. He's with Assam now, and your phenyl nitrate is stuck in the trunk of his car. You wanted to go get it. Because there's no more in Haran. That's the last phenyl nitrate anyone's going to be seeing.
What's his car look like?
White, I think. That's all I remember, white car. So you're really going to do this?
Ryan doesn't like to be disappointed.
You must be pretty tough. If you don't die doing this thing, I just might have an opportunity for you.
Come on, I got your phenyl nitrate.
Oh, fantastic. Bring it here.
Ugh.
I can receive transmissions from all the districts.
People are counting on you.
Whoa,
to help them
careful.
Out. Please, don't just.
There's never a bad time to make a deal. Feel free to browse. I'm sure you have good stuff. Yeah, everything's still for sale. Just be quiet, okay?
That somebody turned on the antenna towers.
You're a lifesaver.
Yeah, Ryan's not gonna think so when I get done with him.
I've got a better idea. Bring him this instead. It's Dialavon, a sleeping aid. Let him cook up a batch with that in it. It'll send Ryze's goons off to Dreamland.
I don't think Ryze will like that.
Probably not, but they could use the sleep.
And there's no more phenyl nitrate, so I guess he's out of business either way. And I like your thinking, Amon.
Something.
Oh, God.
Let me catch my breath now.
Hey, I'm running a special right now.
Now I can receive transmissions from all the distance.
So, at last you are here. I sent for you days ago. Are you always so slow? Perhaps you are resistant to my summons. Good. The strong ones are more difficult, but always so much more worthwhile.
You must be the witch.
Such prideful contempt. But of course you do not believe in such things.
Look, I'm here because I've been told that you have an ability.
You want to know how I walk among the Immortui without drawing their attack? Is that not so?
Huh? Is it possible?
For you? No. You are far too crude and ignorant to obtain such deep knowledge. But there is another way. Something I could make for you.
It's fine, I'd be willing to trade.
You are only here because I wish it. And it is my wish that you have this ability. You will need it to be of service to me. Tonight, you will go to the caves while the volatiles are out hunting. Collect as many black mushrooms as you can carry, and I will use them to prepare a tincture for you. That is all I require from you, for now.
The radio signal is stronger than ever before.
I'm right here. Let's do this.
Ryan, it's me. I got your stuff. Open up.
Oh, thanks. They were just about to torch this place.
Who were those guys?
Competitors. There's no more phenyl nitrate left in Haran, so they were hoping I'd got my last order. Here's something a little extra for coming through for me. Guess this is gonna be my last batch. Pleasure doing business with you.
You know, take some advice. After you finish your deal with Rice, why don't you go somewhere else? Don't stay here.
Way ahead of you, pal.
Yeah, no, I don't think you are.
goes alone when I hear this call. Nice. Hey, you looking for a fight, fuckhead? What the fuck? Where are you going? This ain't over. I'm right here. Let's do this.
Deal.
Ozan, where the hell are you? Talk to me!
That's Kareem on the radio.
Hamdi, answer me! What's going on out there?
Oh, God.
Radio boy, get down!
Arthur! You hear me? I fucking got you!
Cut power to the lift, Karim, just in case.
Kareem, it's Crane. Drop your weapon or you're dead.
What the hell's your problem? This doesn't concern you.
Sorry, Kareem, but Errol Asani is my concern.
You're working for him? You're a fool. I was his bodyguard, okay? After everything got fucked up and they built the wall, we got overrun. He got bitten on the leg. I took him to Randall, the only doctor I knew in the slums, and we cut it off, clean. It was the only way. He would have turned if we hadn't done it. But the stubborn bastard never forgave us. So we parted ways.
So why are you trying to track him down now?
Early on, the authorities evac'd all the political bigwigs out of the zone. Errol told us there was a chopper on the way to take us out with him. Then he got bitten. And with all the shit that happened after that, we missed the flight. But after you turned on the transmitter, we heard Errol asking for evac. And a couple of days ago, somebody responded. From outside. The old bastard's got a flight out, and I want a seat on it.
All right, what about Rice? Does he care about this guy?
Not a rat's ass. This was my business. I just want to get out of Haran.
Yeah, well, looks like you won't be making that flight, huh?
That had already dawned on me. But I'd like to walk out of here.
Look, if I see you again, I'm gonna assume the worst. You got it?
Fair enough. Good luck, Crane. You're going to need it.
Did you find them?
Yeah, I did. Kareem's take on losing your leg was a bit different than yours.
So, you talked to him. Edward was right. You do talk too much. You should leave the talking to people like me, and I'll leave the killing to people like you. However, Kareem was my bodyguard. He allowed me to get bitten, but I don't really blame him for that.
Hey, he saved your life.
By hacking off my leg? The morning I was bitten was the same day they began dropping suppressants. You understand? I told him the antizin drops would begin within hours. All they had to do was wait. Instead, he listened to that idiot doctor of his, and Kareem held me down as the butcher chopped off my leg. Now he thinks I should fly him out of here.
Yeah, well, I told him that's not gonna happen.
You should have killed him.
How about you leave the killing to people like me, huh?
Quite right. I can get you out of here, Crane.
Maybe I like it here.
More likely you've made your own arrangements. Well, they won't work. You've been bitten. I can see it in your eyes. You'll never get past the NCOR quarantine.
Past what?
You see, you have no idea what's going on in the real world. Whoever you think you know, they're not political. And that's the only thing that's going to work now. You don't believe me? Then think of it as an ace up your sleeve. A backup plan. In case you haven't noticed, things don't always work out the way they're supposed to in this town.
Alright, if I'm interested, what happens next?
Two things. The first is we need to paint some markers on the rooftop. There's no paint around here, so you'll have to go out and find some. And the second thing is... well, let's just say you'll be leaving here in a better way than when you arrived. Now, go find some paint. There's a construction site nearby. You should look there. I'll tell you the next task when you've completed the first. Trust me.
Thought we were done for.
To thank you. That was so fucking close.
You need something?
You need something? Get in line. We're already swamped.
I brought you something to brighten your mood.
My lights! You got the bridge lights? How? No, never mind how. None of my business.
And none of Brecken's either. You just tell him you found him in a shoebox.
You're my ace new partner, Crane. I'm gonna take care of you. Tomorrow night, we're gonna be a lot more secure.
There's a lot to be done around the tower. I hope you find some time to take a look at the board.
Wow. Now I can receive transmissions.
Come here. Deal for you.